I hope all of you are fine in this pandemic condition. You all are safe and healthy. Okay, you are not coming to the school and classes are not being done and no practical sessions are being done. But I hope all of you are missing the school, the laboratory, everything. So in this condition also, we will try that some of the experiments we can do at home. So one of the such experiment today we are going to conduct here is to isolate DNA from the supplied plant material. This is one of your major experiment. Well, we are using here the crude method to isolate the DNA, and for that, what are the requirements? You can see the requirements are the plant material, any source of plant material, as in for your syllabus it is given green peas, spinach, papaya, or you can take banana or onion. Then liquid detergent. Liquid detergent is required to isolate the DNA or to separate the DNA from the other biomolecules. As you know, friends, that the cell is having the other biomolecules like proteins, lipids, RNA, carbohydrate. So for that, what we need is the different type of hydrolyzing enzyme. From the theory part, you must have cleared this concept. So as we are using the plant material here, for that we need the enzymes, cellulase, then proteinase, then RNase, lipases, okay. But we don't have those costly enzymes. So for that, we have to use the liquid detergent. Liquid detergent is having those hydrolyzing enzymes that can easily degrade the other biomolecule. And then we need the NaCl. Why we need the NaCl? Because here DNA is negatively charged and it is tightly held with the histone protein. As you know that it is the chromatin, it is present in the form of chromatin fiber. So to extract the DNA from the protein, we are using the NaCl, where positively charged sodium ions will make a seal over the DNA and helps it to separate from the protein. Along with that, we are using the chilled ethanol to separate the DNA. Here DNA is not being dissolved in the ethanol, so it can easily be precipitated out by using the chilled ethanol. Some of the requirements that are the instrument that we need: test tube with test tube stand, beaker, spirit lamp, tripod stand, strainer, and then the glass rod. So let us see what we are going to do, what are the requirements. All you can see, here is a mortar and pestle. Here is a mortar and pestle that we need to smash out the plant material. Along with that, I have the I have the liquid detergent, test tube with test tube stand, NaCl, a strainer, this is ethanol, a tripod stand, spirit lamp, and the for water bath, I have taken water in a beaker and made it hot. Ethanol I have kept in the ice so that it can be chilled by the end of our experiment. So let us begin. As I have taken the source of the plant material is the onion, fleshy leaves of onion. I have crushed it in the mortar and pestle. Do not crush very thinly, right, or very smashly, so that the DNA will remain intact, it will not destroy. Then you need to strain it. If you are using any other dry source, then you can use a small amount of water also to it, as onion is having too much of water content. So I am not using further water to it. Just strain it properly. Take the extract. The other debris will remain in this part, in the strainer. Okay, so I have taken here. I have taken the extract, onion extract. To it, I am going to add a small amount of NaCl. Just use the NaCl properly. check. Okay, the other debris will remain here, and then further I am going to transfer it to a test tube. To it I am going to add the liquid detergent. You can take the dishwash detergent also, the amount that you are taking as your solution, according to that you can use the, you just mix it properly. Okay, now we hope now the DNA is slowly getting out of the nucleus and slowly getting separating from the other biomolecules. Okay, now we need to warm it up. Okay, do not heat, do not boil, just you can put it down. The temperature should be around 60 degree, so touch it so that it should not be too hot or it should not boil. If you will, the temperature will be elevated. If the temperature will be high, then DNA will denature, that you have already read in the PCR technology, where if the temperature will be high, then DNA will denature. Okay, we don't need to do that, so we will just make it warm around 60 to 70 degree. Okay, so after this, now it is a little warmer. Let me take another test tube where I can pour it. Okay, small amount of it I have taken, either from this one or from this one. As DNA will not dissolve in ethanol, but if you will take water, then it will definitely dissolve. Okay, so for that we are using the chilled ethanol. I have kept the ethanol in the ice. Now I am going to add it. Take care that you should hold the test tube in a slant condition and just pour the ethanol on the wall of the test tube very slowly. Slowly you just add the chilled ethanol and without disturbing, keep it for a while, for around 2 minutes. Okay, just keep it. Why should I waste this one? Let me do it again. Okay, again here I am adding the chilled ethanol very slowly to the wall and just keep it undisturbed. So we wait for 2 minutes. After 2 minutes you can find out that DNA is being precipitated out as a white messy cotton like structure. You can see this is the DNA that is being isolated from the onion, fleshy leaves of onion, you can see. And by using a glass rod or the needle you can take it out. You have read about the spooling method, or here I have taken some amount in the petri dish and you can add the chilled ethanol again very slowly. You can add
just see it, the white color mash that comes out. Always keep it in a background, means dark color background, so that you can see the DNA. All you can see, these are the white color structures, right? Very clearly, these are the DNA. Just keep it for just 1 minute, and slowly DNA will precipitate out in the chilled ethanol. Okay, you can see as we are keeping a little more time, the DNA is getting isolated from the ethanol. I am going to add a little more. Chill ethanol, and you can see all this white color mass structure, cotton like structure that is being floating here is nothing but the DNA. Okay friends,
this is what I have explained you. I have done this experiment in the laboratory. In the laboratory situation, how you are going to do it? When you will appear the board exam, practical exam for the CBSE board, but how you are going to do it at home also, very easily, whatever materials that is available with you, that my friend is going to explain to you. Thank you so much friends, have a nice day to all of you. I have explained you how to do this practical at your own laboratory. Now I am going to show you how to do this simple experiment at your home too. So you can see here, I have taken this any plant material you can use as ma'am has instructed. So I have also used onion. I know it is very costly, but you can get it one. Okay. So what you have to do is that you have to crush it, or you can, if you want it to grind it, it will be better. So I have crushed it because I am present at my lab only. So I have taken this one. I have already added a pinch of salt to it because we don't have NaCl at our home. So we can use the salt which is being available here. It is being the salt, you can see here, the normal salt which you use for making any tasty dishes at your place. I have taken a pinch, you can see here, I am adding a pinch to it again to show you people that how to perform this experiment. So this is the onion pieces, I have already crushed it. Now I am going to pour it this solution. Any dish where is being present at your place, you can use it. Just you have to pour it. You can use some glass items which is being available at your place. It will be better if you use something of glass material because it will be easily visible. If you don't have, you can go for steel, no problem. But glassware gives you best vision. You can see it very nicely. So you can see here, it is being, the solution is being poured out slowly. It takes time. So don't get panic. I'm adding some more to it. Strainer is something that is being easily available at your place, or you can go for any cotton cloth, that will be also helpful. If you don't have any glass rod, you can go for a spoon also. Just press it and you want to get the liquid out of it. Okay, so I have collected a little amount of liquid. So I have collected a liquid amount, a little amount of liquid. I am not having much amount, but it will be visible to you people. Now you can see this is a liquid dishwasher is in front of you. This can be anything, okay, for washing clothes also. Dishwasher you are using, you can, sorry, the liquid detergent you are using, you can use that, as well as you can use the dishwasher also, no problem. Slowly you have to add it. A little amount will do. Stir it. You can stir it with the spoon also, no problem. Stir it nicely so that everything should mix up properly. Now coming to the water bath, if you people are not having this glassware, you can take hot water, okay, heat it in your gas, you are having. So now I am putting this one inside this one to get a nice warmth. So when it will get a nice warm, what you have to do is that, I think it will do. Now you can see here, I have taken a very nice thing which is being available at your place. What is this? You can see here, this is a sanitizer. Only one thing just you have to do is that, before doing this experiment, you have to keep this sanitizer in your refrigerator for 1 to 2 hours. So I have already kept it. I have got some ice. I have kept this sanitizer in the ice. Now why I am using this sanitizer to do this experiment, as you can see here, it is being written ethyl alcohol. So alcohol is being present here. Okay, it not only kills the germs, but it can give you the fine result with this DNA experiment also. So while talking, I guess I have got a nice warmth to this particular thing. Now I am going to pour this thing inside this watch glass. You can see here, the onion solution is here. Okay, to this transparent onion solution, I am going to add the hand sanitizer which I have kept it in the ice. Slowly you add, drop by drop. And you can see already a white patchy appearance is coming out. So students, you can see here, can you see this white mesh like thing is being appearing? This is nothing but your DNA. You see how beautifully it is being coming out. After leaving it for 1 to 2 minutes, all these are going to be precipitated at one place. You can see here how the DNA is beautifully, it is being coming out. You can take any needle. You must be having dissection kit with you. So you can take a needle, you can just spool it out. You can see here how I am spooling it, see here. Okay, this is nothing but the DNA. Very clean, very beautiful, a simple experiment which can be done at your place. Okay, thank you so much students. I hope you like this experiment. Thank you.